Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
I recently visited for Umrah and I have some observation. So could you please tell me about this? I find that over there a lot of luxurious type of thing has been pushed up instead of a very neat and clean environment. Like a lot of luxurious things, the hotel charge is fantastic, like 800 riyals per day, which any ordinary city in the world will not have that type of situation. So Islamic, is there any step taken to this extravagance, luxuries and all that? Because every Muslim has a right to go to this place. And if the things are put to the right channel, many people will take the advantage of this. Is there any concrete attention is given to this issues? Because there is a lot of extravagance, expenses and other things, which should be not there in a holy place like Mecca. And even if you see in India, there is a, in any other religion, they have a, this thing, Musafir Khana, or a place where people can say a normal, at very economical rates and all that. So why don't you put some efforts to this?
He was asked the question that when he went for Umrah, he found that the rates of per day in staying in hotels very exorbitant, say 800 riyals, which is very high. Brother, let me tell you one thing. I do agree. The rates are only high during the season. During the month of Hajj, during Hajj period, it's very expensive. And during the month of Ramadan. These two are the only times when the rates escalate. Well, that's the time when more pilgrims come to the holy city of Makkah and Medina. Otherwise, in off season, it is one of the cheapest in the world. 800 riyal, what we're talking about, the peak season. So the rates in hotels close to the Haram is one of the most expensive in the world and one of the cheapest in the world. 800 riyal is nothing. What you're talking about, 800 riyal, is about a 5-star hotel. So 800 riyal comes to about 10,000 rupees. So if you take the rates of the 5-star hotel close to the Haram, by the Makkah, Medina, in off-season, it is the cheapest in the world. Cheapest in the world, I'm telling you that. You can even stay for 150 riyals. 2,000 rupees, no 5-star hotel you'll get. Even for 1,000 rupees, off-season, 125 riyals, I'm telling you that. 5-star hotels. But in season, 2,000, 3,000 riyals, which becomes the most expensive in the world. Your question should have been Umrah, it should have been Hajj. Umrah is normally done in off-season. Except if you're Umrah, during Ramadan. That time, during the last 10 days, it's sometimes even more expensive than Hajj season. But during the other times of Umrah, it is very cheap. A poor person can even stay in a 5-star hotel during off-season, if you want to do Umrah. Now coming to your question, during Hajj season, why is it expensive? Now, fail to realize that according to me, after seeing the facility the Saudi government has given for Hajj, I'm saying because of the Saudi government, it is even possible for a very poor man to do Hajj. The facility the Saudi government gives, if you see the Haramain, both the Haramains, the facility they have, the toilets they have provided. Imagine more than 2 million people coming for Hajj at one time during Ramadan and the facility they have given toilet. They have put Italian marble in toilet. Poor people don't get to live in Italian marble. In toilets, they have put marble. They have escalators. And they take only a few riyals. So as far as the airfare is concerned, number one, the government subsidizes the airfare. Now, because the Saudi government has subsidized the rate for the Saudi airlines, the other airlines for competition, they're forced to subsidize. So even the non-Muslim airline, they're subsidizing now. Why? Because Saudi Arabia started that. So Saudi Arabians say that if you're coming for Umrah or for Hajj, we give 25% discount. Sometimes they give 40% discount. Now, because Saudi airline does that, the other airlines are forced to do it. So they aren't bothered about the Muslims. But if they don't do, then they lose business. So they say, prefer let the rate come down and we have more flights. So they subsidize. Actually, they're making business. But if you normally have to go to Saudi Arabia, it will cost you 29,000 rupees. Normal fare up and down from Bombay. During Umrah and Hajj, it costs 21,000. Subsidized. One third. So first point number one, that fare is subsidized. Point number two, the facility given by government, the tax the government takes for Umrah is negligible. That's subsidized. As far as staying is concerned, eating is very cheap. Eating, you will get all types of food. MashaAllah, very cheap. Pakistani food, this food, that food, fast food, everything. Now staying, what you're talking about the rates is the hotels very close to the Haram, Haramain. Now if your budget doesn't provide you, you take a hotel which is far. I know even during Hajj season, there are hotels which are costing 50 riyals a day. So whether you're staying close to the Haramain, whether 5-star hotel or small hotel, even if you take close to the Haramain, the cost of the land is expensive. The cost of land is expensive. So even if it's not a five-star hotel, it's expensive. If you stay in a hotel close to the Haram, even if it's not five-star, if it's not 1,000 riyal, it will at least be 400 riyal. You understand? Because the land is expensive. Now why the land is expensive? Because it's close to the Haram. So the moment a poor man, when he goes, he can very well take a hotel which is half a kilometer away or 1 kilometer away. What's the problem? And the facility of the government is so good that you can spend the full day in Haram without any problem. So we should thank the facilities given by the government that it is even possible for a poor man to perform Hajj. Otherwise, if there was no facilities, only the air ticket, because now you can do Hajj even 50,000 rupees. You understand? So only the air ticket cost about 20,000 or 30,000, with the airport tax 30,000. It's because of the package. So if you go in a group, if you go as an individual, it will be expensive. If you have the money, Allah has given you the money, you can go as an individual, stay in a five-star. So there are trips going for Hajj for 1 month. So 1 month you're living, lodging, boarding, everything for 30,000 rupees is dirt cheap. 1,000 a day you're paying actually for traveling internal. Jeddah to Makkah to Medina and back. Where will you get 1,000 a day? If you go to America and you want to spend 1,000 a day, when you go to the SODC trips, they're so expensive. So if you compare that with the Haram, for 30 days average, you are spending less than 1,000 rupees. Sometimes you're spending 800 rupees, including traveling, including eating, including staying in a good hotel close to the Haram. There are cheap tours which will cost you only hardly 600 rupees a day. Now 600 rupees a day for eating, staying and traveling is very cheap in a foreign country. It is mentioned in the Quran that when you're going for Hajj, you take some cloth in India, which is not available there. You can very well take that cloth, sell it. And the government gives you permission. So while you're doing Hajj, many people do it free because they take stuff and they spend a few hours a day selling it and they recover the cost. People even make money. So that is no problem. So in Hajj, if you cannot afford it, you can even do business. You can take some material and sell it. Then many people do it. Many of the people, they get material. So these are the facilities given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, and by the government have to appreciate. Now to say that why do they charge doesn't make sense. Even a poor man can go. And there are more poor people coming for Hajj than rich people. More poor people are coming for Hajj from different parts of the world. They do the savings. And alhamdulillah, they have to thank. So all the types of facilities there in the Haramain, whether Makkah or Medina, big hotels are there, cheap hotels are there. There are Jamaat Khanas also. There's Bhori Jamaat Khana, there are Agha Khan Jamaat Khana. There are several. So many Musafir Khanas are there. Now if you don't know about it, that's your problem. There are many Musafir Khanas, not only in the Haram, even in cities. In Bombay, the Musafir Khana Hajj committee is going to the dogs. It's just lying vacant. Who's to blame? We are to blame. One thing is there that you have to realize that you go and tell the Saudi government, why did you put tire marble in the toilet? They want to give you free. So you should go and tell the Saudi government, why did you put tire marble in the toilets? How many people live in tire marbles? So alhamdulillah, they want to serve the Haji because they feel that serving the Haji gives you barakah. Now when you do a trip from Jeddah to Medina and back in the bus, they charge you 130 riyal, which is not possible. 150 riyal is only for going and coming. How is it possible? Then I inquired. They came to know there are many rich people who say that whatever the cost is, we'll pay half. So when you're paying 130 riyal, which for 3 days going to Medina and coming back with the air-conditioned bus, the normal bus fare when you go is 150 riyal. So how can it be 130? It doesn't make sense. So when I inquired, they told me that whatever the cost is, 50% is paid by rich people. They say we want to subsidize it. So if they want to subsidize it, why go in air-conditioned bus? And if the rich people, they want to spend their money in serving the Hajis, alhamdulillah. So there's some rich man who is subsidizing. Some people come and tell me, you know, Ibn Kasir is so cheap, why it's expensive? Because the rich people in Ramadan, what they say, whatever the cost is, we'll pay half. So if the cost is approximately 8,000 rupees, or if it is 6,000 rupees, they say we'll pay half. So you get 3,000 rupees Ibn Kasir. It is subsidized by somebody. So when they want that, let the Hajis get facilities, let the people who come for Ramadan get facility. So why are you objecting? If you don't want it, don't take it. So don't go in the tour, you can go individually. But the thing is that the facility given by the people out there, alhamdulillah, because they respect the Hajis, alhamdulillah, we have to appreciate that. And we have to say that, mashallah, you can stay in a good hotel also, sometime at cheap rate. Sometime if you don't have the money, you can stay in a cheap hotel. Or if you have the money, you can stay in the season in expensive hotel. Hope that answers the question. Yeah, brother.
Now of Arcot.
Arcot, yes.
He has dedicated a building and
for Waqf.
Yeah, and the people can go and stay of free course. Down there. And I think even Nizam of Hyderabad has done it. Maybe
he's not aware. Brother, adding more information, he's right. That Nizam of Hyderabad at that time, he used to give zakat to Saudi Arabia. Nizam of Hyderabad, they used to send zakat they used to send money to Saudi Arabia, and now it is the opposite. So they have got many of their own places to stay, which is free. But again, that's limited. So maybe the place, the room may be 50 or 100. So booking is there. So people are staying free. There are many people live in Nawab of Arcot of Madras. He has got his own place where people can go and stay there free. There, even Abhori Saizan has got, even Aga Khan has got. There are many trusts which have got. And they give free. Some people charge nominal. So depending upon if you want, you can avail. That's the reason so many poor people can also perform Hajj, alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah. Hope that answers the question.